Welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner. Today we're going to be going over the brand new Power BI Gateway experience. Super excited about this. The Analytics Rebel Alliance is counting on you. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, turn on that alarm bell so you don't miss any future mission. All right. So we've been using the Power BI Gateway experience for like 7 years now, and there's been almost no changes in that time. To start out with, it worked fine, right? You could go in, establish a gateway, make some credentials, set some things up, share it out. No big deal, right? 7 years later, though, we have hundreds and hundreds of gateways that are set up, connecting our on-prem data out into the cloud, into Power BI, and it is a mess, and it's hard to deal with. You go into the gateway settings, you go out and use it, and you're just, it could take you an hour to make it the simplest of changes. Today that ends. Today we've got a brand new Power BI Gateway experience, and oh, I gotta tell you, when I saw this, I was a little bit confused, but I started to play with it, and wow, but enough talking about this. I want to get into it. I want to show you exactly what just came out. You're going to be as excited as I am. All right, let's head over to it. All right, so this blog post just came out earlier today. It's May 6th. It goes over and talks about how do you create a data source? How do you get out there and create it? Now, accessing this menu is the same it's always been, just admin settings. Manage gateways, and boom, you're right into it. Okay, now this thing is going to look totally different. You know, creating content's going to be fairly easy. A lot of the checkboxes and all of this stuff didn't change. It's really the how you navigate and see everything inside of your Power BI experience. Link to this document is in the video description below. Do check it out. But let's head over to our Power BI experience and let's go take a look. All right, so from my homepage, accessing the new gateway experience is just what you think, right? I go into settings, I go to manage gateways, and I go right into this brand new experience. Here it is. This is unbelievable. First thing it's gonna land you on is the manage the gateways, right? So these are all the gateways that you've set up inside your organization. As you can see in my demo organization, it's my main system, Kreos BI Enterprise, and that my MSI laptop, you know, that I tinker around with when I'm on the road and stuff, right? But from here, you can manage who installs your gateways. So if you want to restrict who's able to go in and create content or create gateways, you can just assign who's able to do it here, or you can leave it unrestricted. Now, if you're in a larger organization, or frankly, if you're in any organization, I'd kind of recommend you think about turning this on and creating an AD group of who's allowed to make these connections and not. There's just some security items in here that you might want to really take into consideration, especially because we're talking about going from on-prem out in the cloud, making sure that that's secure. This is a great new feature. This has always been available inside the Power BI portal admin section, but it wasn't easy to find. A lot of people missed it. All right. Now, if you were like me and you're looking at this, you go, okay, hey, Chris, this is great. I can see my gateway servers, but where are all my data source connections? Oh, that's what got me. I was a little panicked. I'll freely admit. I said, oh my gosh, we got to roll this back. This is a problem. I had to create a gateway. I had to create a connection and there's nothing here. Well, what's the other thing on here? Oh, it's tenant administration. So maybe not the best name for it, but you turn that off and now you get into the gateway connectors. So super easy, a little toggle switch over here and you're right in. Here's all the connectors that you have inside your system. Again, I don't have a ton because it's my demo environment, but you just, to create a new one, it's the same as it's been in the past. Create a new data source. Now you don't have to go into find the server or the gateway that you're connecting on. You just create a new data source, tell it what server you want to be on, define it, go in and start to create it, and it'll run you through the steps of creating all the new settings. So you know, we'll just run through this one and we'll call this one sample data, sample people. Right? You can see it starts to prompt you along, right? So which of my data sources is going to be? And I mean, really, this just runs you through just like you would any other thing. So SQL Server, right? Localhost, AdventureWorks, W2019 authentication model. We're going to turn that to basic. I'm not going to answer that because I don't want you sneaky snakes going out there stealing and hacking into my stuff. But yeah, as you can see, super easy to get in and get that going. What do you guys think? I was a little scared first. I get it. Like, and there wasn't like a lot of announcements. And honestly, it hit my tenant before that blog post hit. So I was a little thrown by this. So I was a little nervous at first. But the second I got into play with this, I'm blown away. Super excited about it. Thank you guys so much. Don't forget, like, subscribe to the channel, all that good noise. Go out to CareerSBI.com. Check out the Data God profiles that are out there. Join the book club that I got starting up. And if it's more than a few weeks from now, and you know it's run for 8 weeks, but if you're after July of 2022, watch the video recordings of the book club. It's going to be super excited. I'm really pumped about it. Thank you guys very much. You guys have a great day. Take care of one each other. Take care of yourselves. Peace.